Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. Super excited to make a new video today guys about Fiesta MK7. Okay, this one right here guys will be removing and replacing the rear window regulator. If your window doesn't go up and down, okay, I will show if the regulator is bad, how to replace it. It'll be the same for sedan and hatchback, should cover the whole generation guys. We have more than 200 videos, make sure you subscribe. We'll definitely have probably what you need on the channel coming soon. Okay, and we'll find some videos on World Mechanics, our second channel as well. Alright guys, so we'll need to open the door of course, okay. And what we are going to do now, okay, we'll need some door panel removal tools, screwdrivers here we have guys. We'll have the links in the description of the video, the tools and parts that we use as well. So now we need to pry that cap open. Okay, and you have to be careful, okay, not to damage it. You can see where the clip is, okay, right there. So we got the that thing out of the way now. Okay, next thing, we're going to get a small flathead screwdriver. Okay, right here, there is one cap that we need to pop open. Okay, on one side, I think it comes on this side actually, I don't know. Let's see for sure, yep, it's right there. Okay, we got it out. Okay, and we have a screwdriver with a Phillips screwdriver, you can see inside. So we're going to get a Phillips screwdriver. You won't need to use any much tools guys, but if you need anything, we have it in the description of the video, so trying to make your life a little bit easier. Next we need to get a Torx 25, okay, let me show you here. Okay, the star looking bit, okay, right there. So we're going to get that, and right here, okay, there is two screws under the door handle. Okay, check them out. Those are with the Torx now. Okay, so we need to go ahead and remove those all the way. Okay, both of them. Okay, one is out, you can see how long it is, pretty long screw. Okay, working on the second one now. And they're usually pretty tight. Okay, working on this one now. Okay, we're using that panel removal tool now, a white one, and there is a few clips. Make sure guys you stay with us until the end, okay, to show you where all the clips are now, because it's important to know where to apply pressure, okay, so you don't break any. Okay, you can see it's pretty tight. This one, it has never ever been removed. Okay, we got our fingers underneath once you get the two. Okay, and you just start popping it. Okay. You can see it's still having some here and there. Okay, one clip fell out. So we'll show you how to fix that now. Okay, perfect. Now you need to lift it up. Okay, and pull it out of the seal there. Okay, now let me show you how to disconnect this one guys. Now let me take my time here. Okay, right here, this part you need to push towards the back, okay, and when you do that you unhook it. When you're ready to install it again, okay, let me show you, just get it in the thing, and all you have to do, okay, I'm a little bit short here on the cable, you need to just get it on the front, okay, and push it in if you need to install it. Okay, just like that, that's how simple it is. I just wanted to show you so you know what to expect. Next we have the wiring harness for the window switch, okay, right here. You press in on that part, okay, but you need to get a small flat screwdriver or use your fingernail, okay, to press it in. Okay, here the click now, okay, like that. Then we pull it out. Oh, you guys remember how our door, okay, clip right here fell out. Okay, so all you have to do, just get them in and push them in the groove. We still have a few stuck on the door, okay. So with that clip removal tool that comes with the door panel removal tool, it's really easy to remove them without breaking them. We'll have the links for replacement ones because we bought some, okay, for the other door. We needed before we broke one or two. Okay, this one is out as well, and we have just one more now. Okay, let's go ahead and install them on the door panel and show you where all the clips are. You can see in the very rear top you have 1, 2, 3. Okay, after that, okay, you have on this side, okay, right here on the bottom, you have 2. You can see this one, and 2 on the side. So all together we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 clips, guys, that you need to remove. Okay, guys, next, right here, okay, you see you have 2 covers that you need to remove. And those, careful not to break them because they're made out of foam. You can replace them with tape later. Okay, so it doesn't, you don't get any road noise and wind like that. So we need to turn the ignition on now, and we'll need to bring the window down, okay, or the regulator, until you see, okay, two bolts there. Okay, let me show you now, okay, with the window switch installed. Okay, you go down. Okay, those are the bolts, guys, with 10 millimeter socket. Now we will go ahead and turn the ignition off now, and now those bolts, is important not to take them off all the way, very important. You just get them loose, a couple revolutions usually go, okay, like that. Okay, perfect. Okay, now something else that we will need to do. You're going to grab the window, guys, with 2 hands, okay. You're going to grab and pull it all the way up. Okay, one person will be holding it. And now we need to tape it really, really good. I mean, okay, get that part again. Really good, because if it falls, it's going to break later. So tape it, make sure you have good tape. Okay, we're going to install one more just in case to hold this. Okay, like that. And one on the back as well. Just to make sure that everything's good, so we don't have to replace it with a new window. We have the video on our channel how to do that. Okay, perfect. Okay, now we're going to remove the speaker. Okay, we'll just get a screwdriver, and right here you need to push in on the middle part. Okay, and remove the wire with Torx 25 T25. Okay, we're going to remove 3 screws now, guys. Okay, make sure you guys subscribe. Many videos on that Fiesta coming. Okay, hold the speaker for the last one. Okay, out of the way. Next, we're going to remove the window molar with the same T25. We have 3 screws that we need to remove. Okay, that screwdriver, we love that thing. It saves so much work. Okay, perfect. So now we're going to pull it out and show you how to disconnect the wires. It's a little bit tricky there. Okay, you need to squeeze in the middle there and just pull them straight out. Okay, let me show you one more time. Okay, right here you squeeze and you just pull it out. And window motor is out of there as well. Okay, we're going to get an 8 millimeter, the one that comes with those screwdrivers. It's really, really handy, especially for that electric one. We can just use a regular socket as well. Okay, right there. We need to go ahead and remove, okay, all this now. You can see how many we have. Okay, just I think we have only 4 more to go. Okay, just one more on top right here. Okay, next you need to just pull it out a little bit, and then you need to slide it towards the front. Okay, to unlock it right here. It's really, okay, it came out perfect. You can see right there. Let us remove it quick and we'll show you exactly where it is. Next we need to remove, okay, you can see that the cable here for unlocking the car. Okay, so we need to make sure that you can remove that one. Okay, like that, and we're going to push the seal in, okay, so we have more room. After that, there is one clip, Okay, let me turn the light on right here. That there is a thing in the middle. Let me just pull it out and I'm going to show you what it looks like. Okay guys, and this is the clip right there. So what you have to do, okay, this piece in the middle, okay, right here, you have to push on it and pull the wires out. Okay, like that. Okay, so now the window regulator, it's right here on the back side of the panel. With that 8mm, again, we're going to remove two screws, guys. Okay, right there. And now, it's going to come up with that part here as well. So you see what I'm talking about. Now it's important. Okay, here there is a few clips. Okay, on the other side. So let us get them loose and show you how to remove them. Okay, right here you have two teeth that you need to squish in and push them. Okay, you can see on each one of them. So together, three. Okay, this one didn't go in. Okay, it did now. Okay guys, so now you're ready to go ahead and remove the regulator. Okay, right here. Okay guys, you get a new one and you go in reverse order now, okay. I'm gonna show you what to do now. Okay, you need to push in that part first there. Okay, until you hear the click. Okay, from all three of them. Okay, now we're going to go ahead. It lines up there, you can see, so you cannot install it the wrong way pretty much, but just make sure. Okay, and all you have to do, install the two screws now. Okay, get them tight. Perfect. Okay, now it's tricky how you put it together. All right, check out these three canals, okay? You have those on that panel right here, and you need to slide it towards the back after that. But first we need to feed our interior door handle cable through here. Okay, we have... the cable that we need to install as well. Don't forget about this cable. Okay, we need to install the... Okay, that seal here, but actually the seal probably will be better after we install the cable. Okay, let me just grab it here and you just push it in there. Okay, here the click. Perfect. Now let's go ahead and okay, get that seal in. Okay, we just have a little bit more on the back side. Okay. Okay, perfect. You can see the seal looks good. Okay, now we need to go, okay, towards the front. Okay, to get in those holes, okay, right here. So we need to, okay, let me... Okay, those holes, I won't be able to get a camera there, guys. Okay. Okay, almost there. You can get your hand through the speaker, actually make sure that all of them are lining up a little bit. Okay, and once you push them, all of them in, we can slide it towards the back. Okay. Let's see if we can slide it now. Okay, perfect. It went in. Now you need to position everything. Okay, you can see, and we can go ahead and install the bolts. Okay, we got all the bolts in. Now we're just gonna get them tied. Okay, you can see all of them have to be tied. And you see what else we need to do, guys. We need to hook the window up, we need to install the window motor. All that stuff needs to be done. We need to install the speaker, door panel. So quite a bit now. It's not as easy, but that will save you so much money, guys, instead of going to a shop or something like that. Okay, perfect. We got all of them in now. Okay, you need to bring the bolts here now for the window. Next, we're going to install the window motor. Okay, and it goes only one way. Make sure you get the wire in. before you install it. Okay, like that. And if it doesn't go in, you have to turn it left or right a little bit until everything lines up, or you have to move the window regulator up or down by hand, but ours went in pretty simple. Okay, we have three screws now that we need to install with the Torx 25. You can see those white shiny screws. Okay, that's actually Torx 30 right here, Torx 25. Okay, two more to go. It's important how you hook up the window now, because if it doesn't line up on one side, guys, it might not close all the way on left or right side. So you have to reposition it, okay, if that happens. Next, we're going to install the speaker. Now it has three screws, okay, that we actually placed on the seat there. Two of them are there, okay. Okay, this one here now. And we just realized that one of the screws is actually most likely on the back of the speaker, because it's a big magnet. Okay, so check it out right now. So always check that. That's a good thing, guys, to watch a video before we do it, so you can avoid the mistakes that we make. Okay, let's try that again, second try. I think it will work out this time, hopefully. Okay, perfect. Next, we need to remove, install of course the wire. Need to remove all the tape. Now we need to hold the window. Okay, and let's, one person will hold the window, the other one will just kind of remove the tape. Okay, let's get everything. Okay, you can see it's trying to drop already. And you just grab it and you slowly let it down until it reaches the window regulator. Okay, you can see it through the hole there actually, if it's in all the way. Okay, looks good. So now we're going to tighten it. Okay, never use impact or anything like that. Just get it tight by hand. A little bit is enough. You don't want to put too much pressure on the window. Perfect. What we're going to do now, we're just going to give it a try to make sure that it closes all the way up and down, or because otherwise it might need to be, okay, readjusted. Okay, 1 second. Okay, ours closes all the way. Perfect. Okay, we're going to remove the window switch now, because we need to install it on the door panel, okay, later. So now we are actually ready to proceed with the door panel. We're going to install the handle there. You just get it in place and push it in, okay. Let me see if I can shoot through this side. Okay, perfect, it locked in. Okay, now we need to make sure that this wire for the window switch doesn't drop, or we're in big trouble. We're going to install the switch first. Okay, let's install it so we don't have to pop the door panel open again because of that wire. Okay, it goes only one way. Push it in and install the window switch. It goes on the back side first and then the front. Okay, now we need to find all the clips. Just sneak through the hole there and make sure that everything's lining up. Just start pressing it in. Okay, guys, next we'll need to install the two screws under the door handle that you pull there. Okay, and we have one more. Okay, perfect, this one's ready. We have one screw under the door handle right here that we need to install. Okay, and to cover it with the cap. Okay, we still need to get this one tightened. We couldn't reach it all the way with the power screwdriver without extension. Okay, let's just get the one there now. This one is with a Phillips screwdriver on top. And don't forget to install your little cap there. It's facing towards the opening sign. Okay, it goes only one way. Okay, like that. Yep, it didn't go in. Okay, it locked in place. Perfect. We need to install this cap right here. And this is it, guys. So that's how you guys remove and replace window regulator, rear window regulator on Ford Fiesta. Thank you for watching, guys. Please give us a like, leave a comment, and see you guys next time.